This is going to be an awkward video because there is a very exciting collab out right now, especially if you're like an 80s or 90s kid. It is an unexpected, very exciting collab. I was super hype about it. I was looking through the animations. I was talking about it in this video. And then I go to submit for approval and they're like, between the paperwork, we're not going to get this approved in time. So you can't talk about it in the video. Then I'm like, oh, okay. So we're going to delete the mentions of this really cool collab in the video because we have to comply with policy, but definitely check out this current collab in Raid Shadow Legends. Can't say what it is. Use a link, use the QR code. I promise there's an actual collab. I'm not just like, guys, there's like this magical collab. Like, there's an actual really cool collab that just came out in Raid, and you really should check it out because your mind is going to be blown. Today we are going to be building out the masteries. We farm for all the materials, we farm for all the scrolls. We're going to be building out the masteries on units that we should have had the masteries already built out on. Shh, don't tell anyone. I think half of them are probably legendary, so that doesn't really help too much, but let's do the epics first and let's do the rares. I think there might just be one rare that we have. I went to Hell Hades' website. It's a nice resource. He's a Raid Shadow Legends content creator. It's a nice resource for things like masteries build outs because I don't want to like sit there and have to think about every single skill on all of these things. So far I've been just doing them by myself, but I'm just going to copy his stuff for now because that's how I like to do it, because it's much faster and easier, and he's a pro. He knows what he's doing. I don't need to question whether or not it's gonna be correct or valid. I might want to nitpick here or there, but like, oh, I kind of want this one and not that if I think about it. So I'm going to try to not think about it. So we have Godseeker Aniri here. She's actually a really, really solid. I think we can go to the reviews and see. Look at this, 4.9 out of 5. It's not out of 10. 4.9 out of 5. We have some summons to do at the end, which I don't really expect too much. We only have 21 summons. That's why I don't really expect too much. But yeah, 4.9 in so many areas. She's a reviver, though, and I've been using her quite a bit, but the masteries were not done until now. So let's get it started, and I am not on the page for her masteries. And now I lost where I was. Where exactly are we? Hold on. Here it is. Why did that not show up? You guys don't even know what I'm talking about. So the first one we want to do, resistance plus 10. She's a reviver. Extra resistance is nice on her. We have rejuvenation. Increase the amount of healing and the value of shield buffs this champion receives by 5%. Again, reviver, not that shocking. We have, what is this? Decrease the damage received by the champion 8% when this champion is hit with a critical hit. Again, makes sense for a reviver. Super shocking. Heals the champion by 6% of the max HP every time an enemy is healed. Occurs once per turn. He has a 50% chance to remove one random debuff from this. And we're just doing the D. So you can only do two of these three. For those of you that have not experienced Raid Shadow Legends yet, for these mastery skill trees, you can only do two. So for example, if I was to click on something at offense, then I couldn't use the support skill tree at all. It would just be locked off. So we don't want to do that because she's not an offensive unit. She is a support reviver type unit. So we're going to click on this. Max HP, and then it's going to say you can only unlock two branches, so we're going to do this. And then the scrolls in the top left-hand corner keep going down every time we unlock these things in the skill tree. But I made sure that I went through and used their autoplay to farm the dungeon, the Minotaur dungeon, for all of these. That's one of the things that I was working on the last video of the farming dragons. I was like, that's a ridiculous long dragons team. People don't really farm dragons 25. They farm, I mean, they can. There's some legendaries that can, like, just obliterate it by themselves without, like, even needing a full team. Which, I mean, if they're built correctly, which is another reason that you need to build out these skill trees correctly. But, yeah, there's some that are like that. But a lot of people don't even farm those high levels of dragons. So, because you get, it's basically the same stuff as you can get from a couple levels up. So it's not really that critical. What do we have for? But yeah, that's why I just wanted to do it for the achievement, so I could be like, yay, I did it. 50% chance to remove one random debuff from this champion when they lose 25% of the max HP from a single enemy skill. What else do we have here? We have reduced the damage this champion received from a specific enemy by 0.75%. With each hit taken from that enemy, damage reduction stacks up to 6% for each enemy. We have 50% chance of increasing turn meter by 15% when an ally is attacked with a critical hit. Only increase the turn meter once if an ally receives multiple critical hits from a single skill. And then there's nothing on the bottom row for this build out. Okay. 50% chance to counter attack. And this champion loses 25% of max HP from a single enemy skill. I'm surprised there's nothing on the bottom row for this one. Increase value of heals. Increase amount of shield placed by the champion. 10% if target ally has 40% HP or less. We have... some of these are not necessary. Some of these are not necessarily necessary. But this is such a great champion. I mean, not everyone's going to have access to something like this. But we do actually have a much easier champion to get what we've got to do next. So... oh, what else do we have? This little meteor. Cycle of magic. 5% chance of decreasing the cooldown of a random skill by one turn at the start of every turn. Oh, that's nice. I don't have all of these memorized. Increased speed for... if that wasn't completely obvious. So every time I read these, I'm like, wow, it's like I'm reading it for the first time. Because I literally forget everything. It's... I can't even remember names of monsters. Not even in this game, in Summoner's War... can't remember the names of my friends. I'm getting old, guys. I don't know if you guys are having that same issue. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe too much partying when I was young. That's definitely what it was. I go into social gatherings. I'm like, what's your name again, Sparky? My wife's friends do not like me. They're like, he keeps calling all of us Sparky. That's not any of our names. Don't know. He could just say one name. Maybe that might be more offensive. Anyway, increased speed by 8% for each dead out. Don't you love how we're just completely off topic, as usual? And then we have for this last one, increase the champion's turn meter by 20% whenever an ally hero drops below 25% HP. So, nice. Earned by obtaining all positive. Oh, I didn't even finish reading it. Let's do next. We will do what other one? Fushan, blank, no. Oh, we gotta do Steel Skull. Yeah, let's do... where's good old Sparky? Let's do Steel Skull. I already... it's kind of similar. So, I already did the loadout for... offense, but I'm going by his. I think I might have had more of a clan boss oriented one. Well, actually, hold on. No, yeah, mine's actually fine. Mine is mostly the same as he has, so I'm just gonna build the rest out. But he did the same thing as I did. He went down this path for Steel Skull. So let's just finish it off. We'll go here. Heart of Glory, increase damage by 5% when attacking with full HP. We have, what is this, heals by 5%, inflict damage with attack with 50% HP or less. And then that's the last ones. Good, I'm glad we, great minds think alike. I don't know if I'm very much of a great minded raid chat. Maybe passable at best. Some of you guys think not even passable. You are not even remotely passable. But you know, you've been playing long enough, you pick things up. Accuracy, what else do we have here? Base set bonuses for all effects. Increase base stats by 15%. Multiplicative, not additive. We have Evil Eye, decreases the target's turn meter when the champion hits them with the default skill for the first time. Decrease turn meter by 20% with single target skills and 5% with AoE skills. Occurs once per target. There's so many things in this game to make your units much better than you get them. And all these little things add up. Like, these buildouts are going to massively... maybe this might be very obvious to some of you, but for some of you that it's not obvious, it's, like it's not just putting the right gear on it. These mastery trees are going to greatly increase how strong your units are. There's all these extra little, like, little bit here, little bit there, little bit here. It's like grinding runes in Summoner's War. And by the way, if you have not yet downloaded Rated Shadow... hold on! Rated Shadow Legends! That's new to me. Did I forget the name of the game? It's only like the biggest mobile RPG. So use the link. You download, you can scan the link in the description, or you can click on the QR code. How's that for stupid comments? You can scan the QR code, click the link in the description. Also, use the promo code MONKEYKING to get the amazing Sun Wukong on your account as well for free. Wonderful. And then you get the free, I'm going to put some free goodies on the screen as well that you get for starting your new Raid Shadow Legends journey. Also, join my guild because we did some housekeeping and we removed some people that have been inactive and we need fresh new blood. That sounds extra creepy when it's Raid Shadow Legends and there's like vampire monsters that drink blood in the game. But you know, these things happen. Do they happen? These things, drinking blood, it's fine. Let's go. Master Hexer, 30% chance to extend the duration of any debuff cast by this champion. There's a lot. I think I was using it for, I mean, I'm still using it for clan boss, but we just auto run that now, which is nice. Used to not be like that. Back in my day, back a while ago, used to not be like that. What else do we have? Bellower, we gotta do. Let's do Bellower. Bellower is a solid unit. I built him out. Well, actually, I built him out a while ago. And is this all of it? Is that enough, or am I imagining that we need more scrolls? No, this should be enough, right? Yeah, because we tried doing this some more. And I don't really use him for... I use him for CC, though. So. We got the defense, yeah. So I'm hoping this is the right build-out. This is a build-out that's going to work for what I'm using him for. Oh crap, that was not it. That was not the one. Wow. Yeah, I already messed this up. Actually, we can do this, can't we? Yeah, reset for free. Nice! See, I'm showing you all the amazing things already. I don't know that this is going to be the build out that I like the most for him, but I definitely clicked on the wrong thing because I'm not the brightest, am I? Why did I click on that? It was the one below it that I was supposed to click on. I think in my mind, I aimed for the right thing, but my fingers are fat, so. Yeah, close, but not quite. Crit damage, increases shields. Yeah, this is, I don't think this is really necessarily the way I'm using him, though. I'm just hoping it's still going to be better than nothing. So, just a little bit different than I would have built him at if I went like line by line. Line item by line item. Oh my god, guys. I am too nerdy. Yes, let's go line item by line item. Fun with accounting. Okay, so this I did myself. Is it? It's not quite the same as he had. That's fine. Not the end of the world. Let's wait on that one. First hit on each enemy. I just want to make sure that we have enough for... Because I actually use this guy a decent amount. So I want to make sure we get the important ones. And then what do we have left? We have two more that we can do. I care more about the offense than the... default skill, shield. It kills an enemy. That would be nice, but damage inflicted for each debuff and debuff. What else? 50% to counterattack? No. Yeah, I suppose we'll just do. We'll do blood shield, and then we'll do. I kind of disagree with how I want to build him, because I don't want to build him the same way. No, I don't want that. I don't want that one. We'll do this one. I'm okay with that. It was a little bit different than he had on his, but it's fine. I still have to do, what else do I have to do? This one, Biggin, he, I think we gotta finish Foley as well. But you know, let's do summons, because we're just doing so much of that right now. We want to see some summons. Let's go. We want to see how disappointing. I think we got a tiger in here today. Yeah, what is his name? Ragash. Beautiful. Any tiger monster I need. I think he has a bunch of buffs that he does to the team. 25% strengthen and increased speed on all allies. Perfect veil for two turns. And then we got the increase. I thought this was the, it seems like it should be a decreased defense, right? 60% increased defense buff on this champion for two turns. Because the first time I read it, I was like, oh, it's a defense break. No, it's not a defense break. He's defense buffing himself. This is an AoE defense break and a stun. This is the defense break, though. And then we have a defense leader skill. I feel like he should have an attack power leader skill and, like, attack power buff on that. But whatever. We're going to do that anyway. So let's go. Okay, we don't have to make space. That's nice. That's nice. Maybe we'll get an epic. Oh, we got a tournament going on where we can summon and get things. There's
always like 9,000 tournaments going on. That's kind of that's the key to Raid Shadow Legends glory, is do the tournaments,
because that's where you're going to get all your goodies. Oh my goodness. Let's go. Last one. That's where you get all the materials and the crystals and the summons and everything. Nice. Well, I knew we weren't going to get the tiger, so that is that. Lovely. And then we'll do that, and we will continue to farm. We don't need to continue to farm, I've been going through it. I'm trying to actually get the stuff for the masteries. We have more masteries to do, but I don't want to make this video 9,000 hours long. But you can download Raid Shadow Legends for yourself today using the QR code on the screen or the link in the description. Use the promo code Monkey King and get the Monkey King. Sun Wukong is an amazing unit. If you're new to the game and you're like, oh, I want to check out, definitely get Monkey King, Sun Wukong, while you're there, because he is a ridiculous unit for just start the game with, like, one of the strongest units. In some areas, one of the strongest units. So, definitely do that. You also get the other free goodies on the screen that I'm showing right now. QR code, link in the description. You know what it is. And enjoy the collab. Absolutely crazy. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you again to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring the video. I will see you, as always, in the next one.